Hello everyone, welcome back to yet another video. Before I get into today's topic, I just want to take the time to thank all of you for supporting my channel, for liking my videos, for watching of course, and for leaving your comments, and for subscribing. I appreciate you so much, and if you haven't subscribed, then all I can say is, what are you waiting for? Please, please subscribe. All you have to do is click that subscribe button and of course hit the notification bell so you may be notified every time I post a video. Now, today I'm talking about why life is so hard for Zimbabweans in the UK and why your health might be at risk. And also, even though I say UK, really, I'm also talking to people of color who live in the UK, Canada, or other parts of the world like Europe and so forth. Why your health might be at risk. I have spoken about this challenge in some of my previous videos, but really in this video, I want us to take a deep dive into the specifics. And I encourage you to watch till the end because I'm going to suggest a solution that may shock some of you, but some things have to be said. And before I get into these specifics, I just want to say quite quickly that I love the UK. It has been my home for a long time now. I have spent most of my adult life in this country and I love it, and it has provided me with many opportunities that I wouldn't have had otherwise. And I'm covering this topic because it's an important topic and it's important to highlight some of these issues because these are real issues. And also it is through discussion, through highlighting some of these challenges, that we can start thinking about them on a more serious note and come up with solutions, real solutions. And also by highlighting these things, it might help someone somewhere who may not be aware of these things, because some of these things, as I said, are medical and maybe they're being affected. Things are happening in their lives and they may not know why, but if they are able to watch this video, they may start looking into these issues and then help themselves as a result, because these are real problems. These are real challenges that are affecting us today, and they will affect us tomorrow. And unfortunately, they will continue to affect us. And this is why I created this platform, a platform where we can discuss our reality as expats living abroad. And through confronting these issues, that's how we build resilience and thrive. And by now, you're probably wondering, what is this issue that you're on about? Well, the issue is the weather. Yes, the weather. Now, why is the weather an issue for people with dark skin like myself? I have covered this topic in some of my videos, but what I need you to understand is that the issue of the weather goes deeper than we think. Now, today, I want us to look at the evidence, the medical evidence. So I'm just going to be reading a few things here because I don't want to miss anything. Okay. And I want you to understand just how much of a challenge the cold weather is for us dark-skinned people. And by the way, I'm not talking about the fact that in the UK it is cold most of the time. That is not what I'm talking about. If it is cold, you can always wear a coat, you can always wear a jumper, you can always put your central heating on, you can always take measures to warm yourself up. That is not a problem. And also there are times when I even like a bit of cold myself. So that's not what this is about. It's about the health implications of not having sunlight. I've been in the UK for nearly 24 years now. And in the UK, you can go for days, weeks without feeling some sunshine on you. And for dark skinned people like myself, that is a dangerous thing medically. We need the sun for vitamin D. It is an important source of vitamin D.
Vitamin D. Everyone seems to be talking about vitamin D lately. But what's the big deal?
Now, I've written a few things down, and I want us to start by looking at the benefits of sunlight, especially for dark-skinned people. I have here, sunlight helps with stronger bones. It helps to prevent osteoporosis. You need that vitamin D. And I'm going to come back to the issue of vitamin D in a minute. The second benefit is that sunlight improves our mood. I can see here in the UK, when the sun comes out, everyone appears cheerful. Not just appear cheerful, everyone is in fact cheerful. It just helps boost the mood. There's something about the sun that makes people happy. People want to get out of the house, do things, go to the park and that sort of thing. People even want to socialize. There is no time for depression. if the sun is out. So that's why the sun is important. Another benefit that I've got down is that sunlight boosts our immune system. I don't know if any of you have heard or have seen people after they get diagnosed with some disease, one of the things that they want to do is to get some sun, to go somewhere where they can get some sun. They go to the Caribbean, they go to Africa, where they can just soak up that sun. It's for that very reason. There is some healing in the sun. The sun heals. So the sun is important. Another reason as well, or another benefit of the sun, is it prevents cancer. It prevents all kinds of diseases, including cancer. Now, I won't go deep into the medical evidence of that, but I'm just listing some of the benefits. Now, another benefit is that it helps fight depression. As I already stated, people are happy when the sun comes out. They feel like they want to get out of the house, do things. They feel motivated. They feel happy. And you know that if someone feels motivated, gets out of the house, maybe goes for exercise or goes to meet a friend, it just helps with those endorphins, the feel-good hormones. And we already know that when someone is happy, when someone is out there active, it is good for our health. It reduces our stress levels and it lowers our blood pressure, among other things. And now I'm circling back to another benefit, which is vitamin D.
The actual dose that African Americans probably need to reach the target recommended by the Institute of Medicine is approximately 1,600 units of vitamin D per day. And that's vastly different than the guidelines issued by the Institute of Medicine, which recommend only 600 units a day for adults up to age 70. We have increasing evidence that higher levels of vitamin D, for instance, may be very important for improving survival from colorectal cancer. A lot of our research has suggested that colon cancer patients have much lower levels of vitamin D in the blood.
I don't know if you're aware of this, but during the pandemic, COVID-19 pandemic, research findings pointed to the fact that a lack of vitamin D or vitamin D deficiency was a contributing factor to deaths. And the research actually found that a lack of vitamin D or vitamin D deficiency played a role in many deaths among Black people around the world. All of us need vitamin D, but darker skinned people need more of it. And if you're a dark person like myself and you live in countries such as UK, Canada, US, or other countries where you don't get that much sunlight, where it is always cold or where it is cold most of the time, then your health is at risk. So then what can we do to help ourselves to deal with this challenge? Or how can we mitigate this situation so that our health does not deteriorate? And especially as you get older, that's when these things start popping up. When you're young, you may not feel it because you're still young. Your body is still able to fight off some of these ailments. And by the way, it's not just vitamin D. It can be iron levels. It can be vitamin B12, vitamin C, whatever it is that our body needs. As you get older, you start to feel the consequences of some of these deficiencies. That's why we need to take this subject very seriously. So what can we do? If you're a person like myself and you live in the UK, you live in Canada, you live in the US, you live in some of these European countries, wherever you live, where it is always cold or where it is cold most of the time and you don't get that much sunlight, what can you do to mitigate this situation? Well, the first thing that I'll suggest is that you want to have your levels checked on a regular basis. That is the very first thing. You want to know where you stand exactly. But if you're a dark-skinned person like myself and you live in a cold climate, a place where you don't get that much sunlight, it is a given that you will have some deficiency. So in that case, you want to look at the food that you eat. You want to eat foods that are rich in vitamin D. Now you can research this. One type of food that is rich in vitamin D is fish, oily fish, cereals. So do your research. There are all kinds of food that are rich in vitamin D. So incorporate this in your diet, daily diet. This is important. Another thing or another solution is to take supplements, vitamin D supplements. I take vitamin D supplements myself because I have a deficiency in vitamin D. I take all kinds of supplements because, as I already stated, as you get older, some of these things start popping up and you want to do whatever you can to look after your health, especially if you live in such a climate that is cold, where you don't get sun for days, weeks, and months on end. You want to take these supplements. Vitamin D, vitamin C, iron supplements, if you have that deficiency like I do, you want to take vitamin B12, whatever supplements that your doctor tells you to take, take it, because you need it. Trust me, you need it. And another solution as well, take a holiday. If you can afford to get some sun, to go somewhere where it is nice and sunny, like myself, I come from Zimbabwe. Whenever I can, I go back home and soak up the sunlight, the vitamin D that I need. So if you're able to take a vacation, take a week, 2 weeks, a month, whatever amount that you can take to go and get some sun, that will do you a world of good. Not only will it make you happier, will it boost your mood, it will also give you that vitamin D that you need straight from the source, because we need that. And I know, I appreciate that not all of us can afford to go on holiday or can afford to go on holiday as many times as we want, because it all comes down to money, what we can afford. In that case, you want to make the most of the sun when you get it in the UK. Yes, the sun comes out. I'm not saying it doesn't. And when it does, make sure that you make use of it. You take advantage of it, especially when the summertime comes. Go outside, get some sun, because we need that sunlight. We definitely need it because of our skin. And of course, don't forget those things that I've already mentioned: regular checks, food, supplements, and whenever possible, go on holiday, soak up that sun. And the last thing that I want to mention that will help us as a community, especially when it comes to our health and our well-being in general, is to cultivate strong communities. To have that sense of community, to have that sense of belonging, to be united, for us to be social and to have good, strong relationships. Because with all these challenges that I've mentioned, you need people around you. You need to have good friends. You need to have a strong family unit. You need to have people who support you. You need to be happy. You need peace of mind. You need a less stressful environment, because we already have these other issues to contend with. The last thing we want is to be affected by our relationships. That is the last thing we want. So this is my last solution, is to be surrounded by people who are good for you, people who are good for your health, people who won't stress you out, people who are supportive, people who listen to you. All those nice things, all those good things, we need that. And that is a real solution that will help our health, especially if we live abroad. So this is what I had for you in this video. I hope you found it useful. As always, if you want more content like this and haven't subscribed, then consider subscribing. Also, don't forget to like this video, leave a comment, and share. I'll see you next time. Take care.